Hi, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be talking about delay and reverb. Delay and reverb are two of the most popular effects to add to our patches, to add to our sound generating processes. To demonstrate first delay, I'm going to use analog to digital converter. So this is an audio input and it's connected to my microphone. So it's mono, so I'm just going to use a single input. I need to add a little bit of input gain, just knowing that the level needs to possibly be boosted. So it's fader, again, maybe 10 as a maximum. Let's give it a label. Okay, connect that up. So there's my input and some gain. Then, slightly ironically, I'm going to add another volume control down here. For the output level, so that will go between 0 and 1. So that's connected up, and then that can go out to our DAC, digital to analog converter, left and right. Okay, so we should be able to that input gain turn up. So let's we can see on my oscilloscope that as I talk, and you can probably hear my sound doubling potentially, and we can see that we've got audio input coming in, so that's all great. So now we're ready to proceed to our delay. The trick for the delay, this is a really important part, is to use a buffer. The del write, the delay write command, is used to write data coming in to a buffer, because for a delay we need to store the input for a short time and then play it back later, and we store it in that buffer. We give our buffer a name. I'm just going to call mine audio buffer. And we then give it another argument, which is the duration of that buffer, the size of that buffer. It's in milliseconds, so this is going to be a 5 second delay buffer. So then the audio signal simply goes in there, and that writes it out to a circular buffer, reads it back. So that's all good. At the moment, that's probably enough. In fact, that's all good. So that will write what's going to the audio buffer, and we've got a direct signal here for the output. So now what we need to do is to read back our buffer. So there's a del read command, which has similar arguments. It also needs to know the name of the buffer to read from, and it can have a default delay time, which I can set to 0. But of course, what we really want to be able to do is to input a delay time, and that will be milliseconds, and that will be done by this number box here. Or if we're going to continue with our sliders, we can use a slider to set those values from 0, no delay, up to our maximum of 5,000 milliseconds. So this is our delay time. Okay, so far so good. So that's going to read back our delay. What we want to be able to do is to control the level of that delay. So we'll put a volume control in there. That's another slider to control that. Volume goes between 0 and 1. can't delay volume. Oh, I'm gonna stick with my color coding processes. Okay, so we've got input, we've got the delay volume going out, and then that also needs to go out to our DAC. All right, now moment of truth. So we've got our input, our gain is set, our out direct output is going, so we've got direct output. So now if we turn our delay time up a little bit and then turn up our delay volume. Hooray! Okay, so we now have the delayed signal going ahead. There we have it. I can change the delay time, make it much shorter, or make it much longer. And we can mix in some of the original audio. And so there we go, we have a delay. One of the things which remains now is that's just a single tap delay. We might want to put multiple taps, and we could do that by having multiple delay reads. But probably the most efficient thing to do is to just provide some feedback so that the output of the delay gets fed back into the audio buffer, and then that will just circulate around and we'll... So let's make that happen. We need to send some of this audio signal back out, back to the audio buffer. So I'm going to use a send tilde object and give the send message a name, feedback. So that's going to get the audio data. In order to be able to control the amount of feedback, we put another volume control in. So that's there. And I can put another fader to control that volume level from 0 to 1. It's the feedback amount. Okay, and that's connected in there. So that will pass out that, and we can receive that audio up here. Receive tilde the feedback signal and put it into our okay, so getting some errors. I'm just going to call that a slightly different name so it doesn't conflict with some other things I've got running. Feedback sig, let's call it that. Okay, so let's try again. Turn our delay volume up and we should get delay as we do. And we have our original signal. And now if we turn up our delay amount, feedback amount rather, feedback. All right, hello. And so now we've got a great delay working with our feedback operating like so. So this this process of doing this delay is very, very similar to what you might see in delay pedals. Let's just have a look. So this, you know, these digital delay pedals will operate pretty much exactly the same. And here's a schematic just to remind us of what we've actually done. We've got an input, we've delayed it in the buffer, and then it goes out. We've got the original signal going straight through, and then it's being mixed with the delay signal. We take a little bit of the delay signal, feed it back into the input so that it goes around and around and around, but because the feedback level is less than one, it's going to decay over time. So that's how our delay is operating. Okay, so that's delay. Let's move on now to reverb in PD. I will grab a bit of this infrastructure for input over here to build our reverb. And I will also grab a bit of this infrastructure for output, just so we've got separate signal paths for reverb and delay for now. So in PD, there are some built-in reverb units. One of them is called the Rev1. So it's really handy that that's there. It would be possible, of course, to build our own reverb unit using multiple delay lines, because that's in a sense what a reverb is. We could make many, many, many delay lines, all with slightly different delay times, and that would sort of simulate a reverb sound, but it's quite a complex thing to do, so let's stick with the easy path. Use the built-in reverb. So this Rev1 object takes the audio in and out, and needs an argument going in here, which is the reverb time. Zero will give us no reverb, so if we put that up to say 2 seconds, so I can get my input gain going, and then when we go output, hello. All right, so there's our reverb. We increase our reverb time, we're getting a bigger reverb, and so that's all awesome. You can hear the direct signal from the recording that I'm making, but at the moment in our patch we've only got the reverberated signal going through, so it's typical that we would want to also have the dry signal so that we could balance them out. So let's put in another volume control, which is going to manage our dry signal. I'm running out of space for a big slider, so I'll just use a number box for that level. From 0 to 1. Actually, I might have to take it after the input gain. And then it can also go out to the DAC. And in this way, we've got our reverb amount, and we can also control the amount of dry signal as well. So then we can get a balance between the reverberant signal and the direct signal. Okay, so it turns out that in PD there is another reverb plugin, imaginatively called Rev2 Tilde. It's a little bit more complex. As you can see, it's got more inlets and more outlets. It actually has 4 channels of output. So one of the first things is that if we're using 2 in our system, it means that we can now get stereo output. I'm just going to disconnect Rev1 and we'll use Rev2 instead now. So we've got 2 outputs. So what we would really like to do is to make sure that we have another volume control for the other outlet. So there's our left outlet going there, and our right outlet going there. Both of those need to be connected, the left to the left side of the DAC and the right to the right side of the DAC, and I'll use the same level control here to control both left and the right sides. So that's our output. The input is also fairly straightforward. Let's just get rid of Rev1. The input goes in there. So now the question is, what are the arguments for Rev2? You can see that there's a number of inputs. So they are, first of all, the a level, so how much reverb in dB. This is a reasonable amount. Then, in a sense, the liveliness, which is kind of about the amount of sort of feedback that happens so that the reverb is longer or shorter. So those are 2 are quite important. Then there's 2 more arguments that relate to the amount of dampening. First one is, what is the frequency above which dampening will occur? And then the second one is, what is the amount of dampening that will happen? So with that, with all of those parameters there, let's see what that sounds like. I turn the output up. All right, so we now have reverb from the Rev2. I can increase the amount of dry signal as well. So as you can hear, that's all happening. If we make some changes to some of these numbers, for example, this one is the liveliness, which makes quite a big difference. So we are a much shorter, sort of smaller room, and then it can increase to a much more lively sound. Another one which can make a reasonable difference is the amount of dampening. Oops, zero, low is zero. So that's not much dampening, zero dampening. So we should be bright in the highs, and as we go up, it increases the amount of dampening, and the higher frequency components of the reverb are being dampened, are being reduced in volume. This output is controlling our reverb level. This 100 is also controlling it, but that's close to maximum for that, so we can use our fader to control the amount of reverb, and this is now controlling the amount of dry signal. So that's pretty much reverb in PD. There is, however, a third reverb algorithm, Rev3, imaginatively called, which takes the same arguments as Rev2. So we won't demonstrate this, but it's very similar. One of the differences is that it has an extra input. This particular system, what am I doing? I see there's my, let's turn that down. This particular Rev3 has two inputs, so you can have stereo coming in and stereo going out, rather than just mono going in and stereo coming out for Rev2. And if you recall, Rev1 was mono in and mono out. So that's all of the reverb and delays, and of course we can make them all play at the same time. So let's turn up both our delay and our reverb. And if we wanted to get very flash, we could connect the output of our delay into our reverb and chain them in that way. But I will leave that as an exercise for you to do, and see you in another video. Thanks.